State Capel Arena for today's CIAA matchup between the Panthers of Virginia Union University and the Broncos of the Fayetteville State University. Today's matchup will be the 60th meeting between the Panthers and the Broncos. The first meeting was 93-82, victory for the Fayetteville State Broncos in 1972. And the previous matchup was January 6, 2018, when the Panthers won 88-59 in Richmond, Virginia. Defending CIAA champs hold a 43-16 series advantage over the FSU Broncos and entered today's game with a 6-7 overall record and a 3-1 conference record. Fayetteville State will look to defend the Capel Arena with 2-9 overall and a 1-3 CIAA record. Both teams are on a one-game win streak. The Panthers beat Shaw 19-79 Thursday night in Raleigh by the Broncos shot Lincoln, Pennsylvania School 77-73. We have our national anthem coming up next.
All exits are illuminated with red signs that should be used to exit the building in the event of an emergency. Please exit in an orderly fashion or move away from the building once outside. During your stay, please note your fellow fans. If you see someone in medical distress, please notify the nearest security guard or campus police. For your convenience, our concession stands are located near the main entrance and the right corner of the concourse level. Restrooms are located near each concession stand. At this time, ladies and gentlemen, please rise. Gentlemen, please remove your hats as we pay honor to the United States of America with the playing of the national anthem.
Hi, I'm Anthony Bennett, Director of Athletics at Fayetteville State University. Over the years, FSU athletics has become synonymous with championships and pride. FSU's vision for athletics is to build upon our rich history by providing our student athletes with a comprehensive athletic experience, which includes a quality education and the tools to be competitive in their respective sport. Our vision has led us to the establishment of the 1000 Broncos campaign. The 1000 Broncos is an annual fundraising campaign dedicated to providing scholarship opportunities for deserving student athletes. We look forward to collectively supporting the next generation of Broncos. We need your unconditional support as we pursue becoming one of the premier athletic programs in the country. I proudly serve our student athletes daily. I encourage you to impact a Bronco student athlete by becoming a 1000 Broncos member. You can find out more about our 1000 Broncos program by visiting www.fsubroncos.com or calling 910-672-1314. With you, the future looks bright for all white and blue.
The CIAA was founded in 1912 and has been a continuous champion for academic and athletic excellence for over a century. A crown jewel rooted in tradition, leadership, and community, the CIAA continues to educate and empower the future leaders of tomorrow. Through our commitment to academics, our support of the community, our enhancement of the student-athlete experience, and the engagement of our alumni and fans.
Now, let's meet the starting lineups for this afternoon's game.
All right,
between
and we're
the
back.
Panthers of Virginia Union.
This CIAA matchup between Virginia Panthers and the Fayetteville State Broncos should be a good one.
First for the visitors.
We have some key players in this game.
Guard,
what is your take on the key players, Jordan?
Key players for the Panthers include Demarius Witt, who averages 15.9 points a game.
At guard,
Will Jenkins, who secured his fifth double-double in the previous Shaw matchup. He leads the team in rebounds, averaging 8.8 per game. For the Broncos, Will Richmond stands out as a leading scorer with two 20-point games, naming him the CIAA Newcomer of the Week. Joshua Bryant, high flyer, averages 9.5 rebounds per game, leading with 10 rebounds against Lincoln. Denzel Host looks to add to his FSU career total of 457 points. Hopefully he gets something going around the three-point line.
And now we'll go over your starting lineup for the Broncos. At guard, you have the senior out of Greensboro, North Carolina, Jaquel Richmond. He played at Middle Tennessee in 2014-15. He's a newcomer to the CIAA, actually getting the newcomer of the week at the UNC Nashville game. Your four for the Fayetteville State Broncos, who have Raymond Pratt, the junior out of Greensboro, North Carolina. He has five double-digit games. 15 points is his game high. Then you have your junior out of Shelby, North Carolina, a 6-foot guard, is ranked 5th in CIAA in 3 points per game with 2.18, and ranked 6th in the CIAA in 3 points attempted, so that's 74. You have your next guard, Joshua Bryant, the junior out of Fayetteville, North Carolina. He attended 71st High School. He has a career of 759 points in 3 seasons, career high 27 points on November 24, 2017 against Valdosta State. And then finally at your center, you have Giles Webster, the sophomore out of Chesterfield, Virginia, 3 seasons at Concord, averaging 5.1 points a game and 5.97 rebounds last season at Concord in 29 games. For the Virginia, the Panthers, you have the guard, Demarius Pitts, the freshman out of Clinton, Maryland. He's a shooter and a big-time scorer, loves to pull up. Your next guard, Eric Bowles, the senior out of Petersburg, Virginia. He is a backup point guard and can turn the ball over quite often. Your sophomore, Jordan White, out of Frederick, Maryland, is the forward. And he is a driver and has a high motor and an active on the glass. Then you have your next four, Raymond Wright, the freshman out of Suffolk, Virginia, 6'7", four, good athlete, active on the glass. And you have your junior, Will Jenkins, from Baltimore, Maryland, maybe the best player on the team, runs the floor very well. We have the tip-off coming up next. Well, before we get this tip off, Jordan, what is your expectations for this game real quick?
I expect the Fayetteville State Broncos men's team to come out here and continue with that high level of play that the guards put on last game against Lincoln. Joshua Bryant showed out, as well as Richmond, just driving into the paint, getting their teammates involved, playing good defense. Fast break points were the name of the game. I expect them to pick up to continue that same pace coming into this game. As you see Richmond getting the ball already and coming back up court on that turnover.
Broncos setting up the offense.
Player who really stood out last game against Lincoln was Nakia Rivers, ranked 21st in CIAA in scoring average.
That's Josh Bryant with the penetration and layup, and he misses. Rebound Broncos. Raymond Pratt with the putback, and it rims out.
Raymond Pratt stepped in very high voltage-like in clutch time last game.
Balls out of bounds. Possession remains to the Panthers.
And the Broncos, Raymond Pratt with the emphatic block.
Pratt has 5 double-digit games this season. 15 points is his game high. If they can get him going, man, he's going to definitely be a piece to help them win this game.
Absolutely. Panthers having a hard time inbounding the ball.
The Broncos are making Virginia Union work for everything early. See some tight defense going on in these early possessions.
And you see the Panthers trying to get their offense set up. 9 seconds on the shot clock. Penetrate, layup, misses. Broncos with the rebound or the save, and it gets back in the hands of Virginia Union, and he gets charged with a travel. That's Will Jenkins with the travel call.
Well, Giles Webster took that travel call there. He spent 3 seasons at Concord. He averages 5.1 points and 5.7 rebounds last season at Concord in 29 games. He's only a sophomore, though, man. 6'7". A big guy.
All right. Broncos swinging the ball, trying to find a shot. They get a shot off, and that is Jaquel Richmond, the 6-foot guard. Virginia Union bringing up the tempo with a penetration and a layup.
They want to answer Richmond because if he gets going soon, this could be a spread it out lead, I'll just say. But you want to see Bryan and Richmond going early.
Broncos turn the ball over. Virginia Union on the break, slowing it down.
The Broncos averaging only 11 turnovers a game. That's under two.
Eric Bowles with the penetration and the missed layup.
I apologize. That's under two of what their opponents are averaging.
Jaquel Smith is an outstanding guard, averaging 20 points a game. Again, he's a guard that played at Middle Tennessee in 2014-15 at D1 school. So I'm expecting him to be that point general for the Broncos.
Most definitely a floor general. Always want to see the ball touch his hands on possessions when coming down the court.
It's clear that the Broncos are playing through him.
He reminds me a lot of point guard Dawson from the past, who was a lot like a floor general, but very, very capable of shooting the deep ball. But likes to get his teammates involved.
And that was Jaquel Richmond losing the ball, deflected by Virginia Union. Possession stand with the Broncos. And that was Denzel Haas with the spin and the layup.
Now, Haas is a very dangerous offensive threat, man. He's known for his three-point range, but that there shows you what he can do in the paint.
Raymond Wright misses the three. Broncos bringing the ball up the court.
That was a real crafty spin move by Holst on that last possession.
Absolutely.
Penetration by Richmond, and he'll hit that.
Richmond.
That was Richmond with the floater, the mean Chris floater.
Richmond looks like he came to play early in this game. He's getting out to a high velocity pace on offense fast.
And that's Will Jenkins going to work on the inside. Turn around, layup, he misses, but he gets fouled. He will be going to the line for two.
Bronco foul on number four, Raymond Pratt. That's his first, team first. On the line, shooting two for the Panthers, number 22, Will Jenkins.
And Will Jenkins is a 57% free throw shooter. He comes in this game averaging 14.5 points a game and 50% from the field.
And the Panthers are a 64% free throw shooting team as a whole, so
he knocks down his first.
Yeah, we got
it. Fayetteville State Broncos had a very, very good outing last week on field goal percentage wise. Didn't miss a lot of shots, especially in the second half.
As he knocks down his second.
And last game against Lincoln was a shootout early in the game for Lincoln. Later in the game for Fayetteville State, I would say.
And they hit Josh Bryant with a travel. Ball out. The backdoor cut by Demarius Pitts, and he nails the layup. Broncos got to do a better job of defending that backdoor cut. Oh, I think he got away with a charge.
Broncos playing their style of tough basketball. They like to be physical.
And that was Denzel Haas knocking down the three. 5 points early in this game. He seems like he's going to have a good one today, Jordan.
I tell you what, if Denzel Haas can get shooting, man, give him the ball. He has a green light when he gets hot. We saw him put up 27 points in a game last season in the CIAA tournament.
As it goes to the Broncos.
As the Panthers turn the ball over.
Substitution into the game for the Broncos, number two, Xavier
Broncos
Williams.
Broncos getting possession.
Number 13,
you have a substitute. That's a substitution. That's Mark Burton coming in for Denzel Holmes.
You see Coach Spencer getting into Denzel Holmes' ear. Getting him a little bit of coaching tips. Josh Ryan looking to get into the paint, it seems like. Hasn't been able to get in there yet. Drives and kicks it back out. Richmond missed that three-point attempt.
That's Mark Murray with a three-point attempt. Now he nails the three. Broncos. Broncos going up 12-6.
Now this kid, Mark Burton, man, he really put on a big game last game against him. He came out late, hit some three-pointer. Four double-digit games this season. Season high is 19 points. And he made 5 three-pointers in that Elizabeth City game. So definitely can get hot from three-point range. Career high is 20 points against Clark Atlanta.
And they hit Josh Brown with the travel. Broncos coming out strong in this game, leading this game 12-6 with 14 minutes and 22 seconds left in the half. For all the up-to-date information about Fayetteville State Athletics, visit the official FSU Athletics website at www.fsubroncos.com. Also, keep up with FSU Athletics on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube at FSU Broncos, as well as on Instagram at FSU_Broncos. What is your take on this game thus far, Jordan?
Oh, man, the guard play has been beautiful for the Fayetteville State Broncos so far. Will Richmond stepped up early, man, with some deep shots. Trey Burton, as you saw, he's trying to get hot. Denzel Hoshin starting to make some three-point shots. I mean, if they can continue with their field goal percentage, just continue to, you know, complete these three-point attempts, this league can get out of hand. It's 12-6 right now. The Broncos are up. But I expect Richmond to come out still fiery and lead this team as we expect them to.
That's very intense in the game for the Panthers. 4 points. Denzel Hoke for the Broncos, 5 points. 4 points for Jaquel Richmond.
Broncos shooting 66.7% from the three-point line right now. I think Coach Spencer's happy.
Absolutely. DeAndre Thomas at the top of the key. He passes it.
Now that could have been called something possibly on that rebound.
Jared Biles setting up the offense. He passes it to Raymond Wright. Jordan Wright with the penetration, the layup, he misses, but he gets fouled. He'll be going to the line for two.
Bronco foul on number 45, Will Brown. That's his first, team second.
That was Will Brown with the foul.
On the line shooting
foul.
Two for the Panthers, number
Will
14,
Will Brown, I gave him a nickname,
Jordan,
man.
White.
I call him Block Boy. And it's because he's emphatic when he comes to blocking shots, man. He put the ball right down the offensive player's throat. We saw last game where he pinned a few shots.
To the game for the Panthers,
Jordan White
number 12.
His first. Jordan White is a 47% free throw shooter. Only averaging 7 points on the year. The 6'6 forward out of Frederick, Maryland.
Also to the game for the Panthers, number 0, Terrell Leach.
See a little bit of miscommunication at first, but the Broncos get it together and get them down the ball.
Virginia Union seems to be pressing now. That's Jaquel Richmond getting the ball across the half-court line.
I'm not surprised they're pressing, man, because these guards have started off as a shooting clinic as Burton takes another three.
He misses. Rebound.
Falls out of bounds.
Rebound was by Will Brown.
To the Broncos.
I think Panthers did a good job of blocking that putback.
I think that was a foul. I think he got Will Brown's arm. I don't think that little guy got up there where that ball was.
Jaquel Richmond with the inbound. And they trap Will Brown. And he steps
Falls
out of bounds.
Possession goes to the Panthers.
You got to be able to have better awareness on the court than that right there.
Absolutely.
You want to see the pass right away.
That's Jamel Smith bringing the ball up the court. He finds DeAndre Thomas at the top of the key.
He passes it to Demarius Pitts, and he loses it out of bounds. Broncos get the possession.
Possession goes to the Broncos.
Broncos are real scrappy. Into the game for the Panthers, number 15. They can cause a lot of turnovers. Only two right now so far for the Panthers, but I expect to see that number increase as the Broncos get feisty on defense.
That's Jaquel Richmond on the wing. He finds Nakia Rivers.
Rivers can get real crafty on that dribble, man. He's always looking for someone to hit with the assist, but he definitely doesn't take his shot off the table.
And that was Will Brown.
Panthers foul on number 15, Jordan Peebles. That's his first team first.
Panthers with the foul. Jaquel Richmond on the inbound. He finds Nakia Rivers in the backcourt. That's Nakia Rivers for the three. And he nails the three. I'm going to go up 15-8.
Nakia Rivers is a baller, man. Get this. He was voted to Gannon Garrett. Gannon's Gary Miller Classic All-Tournament team. Most stable in the basketball community. Nakia Rivers was invited to that. Season high 24.6 double-digit games.
And Jaquel Richmond finds Will Brown, and he loses it. Panthers on the break.
Will
That's
Jenkins.
Will Jenkins with the blow-by layup.
Burton went for the steal there, and he just missed.
Nakia Rivers for three, and he knocks it down for his second three of the ball game.
Nakia Rivers is very confident in his shot. Once he gets going, he will pull it, and he's expecting every one of them to go in.
Broncos shooting 80% from the three-point line.
That's outrageous.
Marius Pitts trying to create some space. He passes it to Jordan Peebles. He misses the layup.
Will Brown going for that emphatic block like I was speaking on earlier.
And Trey, I think, Burton. They missed Will Jenkins with a travel.
Possibly. Trey Burton will get called for
Bronco
that foul.
Number 13, Mark Burton. That's his first team third.
You hate to see someone get called for a foul after a blatant travel call.
For the Panthers, number
when
15,
the Broncos should have got the
Jordan
ball going down the
Peebles.
Other way. That's Jordan Peebles going to the line. He misses his first. Jordan
into
Peebles
the game for the Broncos, number 12, Jacob
57% free throw shooter.
Also in for the Panthers, number 14,
six
Jordan
guard out of Emporia. Every time I think of Emporia, I think about going through there and getting caught up in that traffic in the area where you don't want to speed.
Yeah, man, it's the worst place to be. Driving.
Broncos bringing the ball to the court. Nakia Rivers passes out of the trap.
They put in number 12, Jacob Crutchfield, the freshman out of Greensboro. Doesn't see many minutes, but when he does, he's a 43% field goal shooter. So.
That's Mark Burton on the corner, on the wing. Mark Burton finds Xavier Williams for the layup.
Williams.
Right at the buzzer.
Gotta love the awareness of Mark Burton to penetrate and get that pass off so he can get a layup before the shot clock.
Xavier Williams is feeling a little hyped up right now after that big play.
That's Jamel Smith setting up the offense. He finds Will Jenkins in the interior, and he gets blocked by Will Brown.
Block boy. That's block boy Will Brown, man. He will pin your shot at 6'10".
And that was Mark Burton who found himself in trouble. He gets fouled.
Let me tell you something about Will Burton. You know what I like about Will Burton? He's not one of those tall guys who can't jump. He's tall and he can jump. And he's not just skinny, you know. These guys are strong, too. So he's jumping out of the gym. He's swatting shots, pinning stuff at the top of the backboard. You don't want to just throw up any lobs or any kind of layup. You better dunk it when you get around real Brown.
You can definitely see his athleticism around the rim. That's Jacob Crutchfield setting up the offense. And Mark Burton finds Xavier Williams, and he knocks down the three. The Broncos are having a hot streak from the three-point line.
You see Xavier Williams is cheesing at his coach.
The Broncos have made 5 from 6 from the three-point line, shooting 83.3% for the game.
I tell you what, they're not taking advantage of this. They're taking advantage of this opportunity against the defending CIAA champions here.
And offensive foul today. 14, Jordan White.
That's an offensive foul on number 14, Jordan White. His first foul.
Media timeout.
Students, parents, fans, and alumni can now represent their favorite CIAA team by purchasing exclusive gear at BroncoFanshop.com. BroncoFanshop.com offers a variety of Fayetteville State merchandise, from the athletic apparel and jewelry to pets, accessories, and tailgate supplies. For discounts and promotions, visit BroncoFanshop.com.
All right, we got the winner. Congratulations, Hakeem Murphy. You just won yourself a prize pack sponsored by Buffalo Wild Wings. It's the Buffalo Wild Wings Scott Shop.
What is your take thus far for this game, Jordan?
I like what I see so far, man. The Broncos coming out confident. They're shooting their shots. Getting some fairly open looks. Doing a very good job just on the perimeter, basically, man. Only 6 points in the paint, but that's okay. As well as playing in the half court. They've been doing a very good job playing in the half court. We just see the Broncos getting out running. One of the best running teams, actually, in the CIAA. But this game, man, their guards have just been taking advantage of the half court. Like you said, 83% from the field, from the three-point line. Can't get much better than that.
And surprisingly, the Broncos have 0 steals so far. And that was Marquise Crutchfield missing the layup, grabbing his own rebound and putting it up for 2. He was going to the line for 1.
As you see, Marquise Crutchfield, 6'5", 225. I think he holds about 50 pounds of that in his biceps, man. He just got big body on those guys.
Marquise Crutchfield, the center out of Durham, North Carolina, will be going to the line.
Shooting plus one for the Broncos, number 33, Marquise Crutchfield.
Well, it says here he has not made a free throw all season. Man, he misses his.
Yeah, the big guy is known for a rebound.
And that's Nikia Rivers on the break. The numbers are against him, so he will slow it down.
He called right back for it. I think he wanted to get it back and take that three-point attempt.
Jacob Crutchfield finds Xavier Williams on the inside. He passes it out. Mark Burton. Crutchfield on the interior to Crutchfield. He goes up and he gets blocked.
Ball's out of bounds. Possession goes to the Panthers.
Possession goes to the Panthers. Jamel Smith bringing the ball up the court.
The Broncos, no steals yet.
That was Will Jenkins going to work on the inside. He misses the shot.
Ball
goes out of bounds. Possession back to the Broncos.
Yeah, no steals yet for the Broncos, but a big part of that is because Virginia Union has just been giving them the ball back. They really haven't had to steal the ball yet. Ball's going out of bounds.
Into the game for the Broncos, number 4.
A lot of missed attempts. The Panthers only shooting 21% from the field right now, so the Broncos haven't had to steal the ball.
And that's a good observation, Jordan. That's 3 turnovers for the Panthers, and none of them were stolen. All of them going out of bounds. Nikia Rivers gets ripped.
He split 2 defenders there on his way up the court. He just lost the ball.
That's Terrell Leach for the layup. He misses. Rebound. Raymond Pratt. Mark Burton bringing the ball up the court. Crutchfield setting up the offense.
I just knew Mark Burton was going to take his chance for three.
That was Nakia Rivers with the penetration and the step back. He airballed that one.
Rare air ball from Nakia Rivers.
And that was Will Jenkins. Jenkins making the layup on the inside.
This kid Will Jenkins, he's their best player. Extremely athletic, runs the floor well, number 22. So the Broncos have to keep an eye on him.
And that was Crutchfield with a no-look pass to Pratt. He misses it. Rebound Crutchfield. He goes up, he's fouled, and he's going to the line for two.
You want to see Crutchfield take that all the way in and not pass it off to Pratt in the first place so they can get that quick bucket underneath the basket.
On the line, shooting two for the Broncos.
Again, Crutchfield is a center out of Durham, North Carolina, who has not made a free throw all year. Let's see if he can get his first. And he makes it.
So he'll go to, what, 1%?
Into the game for the Panthers.
We will have a substitution for the Broncos. That is number 20, Joshua
Bryan. Number 33, Jordan
Thornton. Number 3, Jaquel Richmond.
In for the Broncos, number 10, Denzel Hosh. Number 3, Jaquel Richmond.
That was Will Brown coming
off. Number 20, Joshua Bryant.
And Mark Burton. Crutchfield makes his second. That would bring that average up, Jordan.
Yeah, let's bring it up some, tad bit. 2 for 2 on that one.
Jamel Smith bringing the ball up the court.
You see Josh Bryant, man. He's got the mismatched shoes going. Blue one and the orange one.
And he gets deflected out of bounds. Ball remains with the Panthers.
Richmond, that's his first, team fourth.
So what do you think about those mismatched shoes, Jordan?
I mean, if they're going to distract the other team, you know, that might help. I don't know. Maybe they make you feel, you know, you look good, you play good. So maybe it's a confidence type thing. I tell you what, I want to see Josh Bryant walk on the moon with those shoes on.
Will
you know
Jenkins.
He's very capable.
And that was Will Jenkins knocking down a jump shot, showing that he can expand his game. Raymond Pratt penetrating, lays it up, and knocks it down the layup. Broncos lead this game 29-14 with 6 minutes and 45 seconds left in this half.
I'll tell you what, man, Raymond Pratt, when he gets around the rim, he's dangerous. He finds his way. He's long. One of those 6'5 guys.
And that was Will Jenkins with the turnaround. Jaquel Richmond bringing the ball up the court, passes it. Josh Bryant.
I don't like the Richmond slow down, man. I want to see him pull up and take some more shots. That's what they were doing so well at the beginning.
And that was Josh Bryant finding Crutchfield on the inside for the two.
Crutchfield
using that big frame, man, to get those guys jumping. Finds the easy layup underneath. Can't complain about that.
Jenkins with the ill-advised pass. Turnover to the Broncos. Bryant on the wing, he penetrates. Lays it up. Oh, and that was way off. Rebound, Panthers. Look like they hit Crutchfield with a foul.
And you see Coach Spencer just staring down Josh Bryant. After that bad shot attempt, gotta find the pass. Denzel Hosh is in the middle. On the wing, wide open.
Into the game for the Broncos, number 21, Giles Webster.
Have a substitution, Giles Webster coming in from the Broncos.
See Giles Webster coming in, another 6'7 guy, man.
And for the Panthers, number 14, Jordan
Concord, three seasons at Concord.
And that's Terrell Leach knocking down the three from the corner. Assist to Jamel Smith.
Richmond almost got there, man, to get a defense. He just got there quick enough to get a hand.
Richmond doing a good job of passing out of that trap. Pratt to Richmond. Hop step layup. And he knocks him down.
Richmond.
And Richmond getting back hot again. I guess he heard me over here talking. That's 6 points now.
That's Jordan White. Well, he passes it to Jamel Smith. And they get Bryant with the and one.
That's his game for number 12, Jamel Smith.
Jamel Smith going to the line for one.
Bronco foul on number 20, Joshua Bryant. That's his first team six.
Sneaky 6'6". In a driver, man. Ultra quick playmaker. Instant offense type guy.
Come on, y'all. Check it out, y'all. How low can you go? Can you go down low? All the way to the floor? How low can you go? Can you bring it to the top? Like it never, never stop. Can you bring it to the top?
Fayetteville State Department of Athletics continues to celebrate the contributions from our 1,000 Bronco members. The 1,000 Broncos campaign is an umbrella organization designed to generate scholarship support for Fayetteville State University Athletics. The campaign helps to ensure that FSU student athletes enjoy the best possible athletic and collegiate experience. Our organization oversees fundraising efforts, initiates communications, and planned events that seek to connect alumni, parents, and friends with Fayetteville State University Athletics. With the goal of achieving and sustaining excellence into an intercollegiate athletic. For more information on joining the 1,000 Broncos campaign, contact Mr. Michael King in the office of FSU Athletics at 910-972-2565 and become a part of a dedicated group that is proud supporting champions. Fayetteville State Broncos beat this game 31-21 with 4 minutes and 47 seconds remaining in this half. That's Jamel Smith going to the line for one.
Jamel Smith.
Jamel Smith, a 79% free throw shooter on the season. He misses that one.
That's the broadcaster curse right there.
Ironically. I'll make sure I put that curse on every time they go to the line.
Well, Richmond setting up the offense faster than Denzel Host.
And the guards are just working it around amongst themselves right now. Maybe possibly looking for some penetration.
Richmond for three. It rims out.
You're not mad at that shot, though.
Yeah, I think the ref missed the over-the-back call. And that was Demarius Pitts going up and under. Rebounds Bronco. Oh, a nice little pass to Richmond for two. And he misses.
Richmond came down on that ankle a little weird.
Panther foul on number 14, like Jordan White. That's his second, team six.
Foul against Jordan White, his second team. Richmond taking the ball out.
Into the game for the Panthers, number 22, Will Jenkins.
We have a substitution, Will Jenkins coming in. Or Jordan White.
You know they're glad to see Jenkins back in. That's their best player. Junior Ford.
That's a bad turnover. Balls
out of bounds. Possession goes to the Panthers.
I'll tell you what. The Broncos have done well against Jenkins so far. The kid out of Maryland is the best player. He's 14 and a half points per game. Right now, the Broncos hold him down to eight in this first half.
Ball's out of bounds. Possession remains to the Panthers.
And that was Denzel Host getting his hand on the ball.
Is that Courtney Best? Over there by the door, I think it is. Some more FSU alum in the building.
Jamel Smith passes it.
Richmond is also a presence on defense as he gets active with his hands in that passing lane.
Looked like it was out on the Broncos. The Broncos wouldn't get the ball. That is Jaquel Richmond bringing the ball up the court.
Once again, the guards come down and they're just passing it around amongst themselves. Josh Bryant playing somewhat of a point forward right now. You see him down in the paint.
That's Raymond Pratt with a jump shot. Miss. Rebound Panthers. On the break, Jalen.
That's just good for Will Jenkins.
I don't think that was a foul. That was called. But like I was saying, Josh Bryant, sit him down in the paint.
Richmond.
He's actually leading the team in rebounds.
Team 7.
Russell Westbrook-esque.
Into the game with the Broncos, number 2.
So you
Xavier
see him down
Williams,
on the block in the paint.
Number 11, Nakia Rivers.
And you really don't lose any presence as far as rebounding goes.
The Panthers,
and you
22,
also gain a mismatch on
Jenkins.
The other side of the ball speed-wise.
And that's the Broncos with a substitution, Xavier Williams and Nakia Rivers entering the game. Will Jenkins knocked down his free throw. A 57% free throw shooter.
Richmond.
Richmond loses it but recovers. Passes to Bryant. Bryant with the penetration.
Richmond, when he gets going, man, sometimes he gets a little wild with the ball. You saw him lose one at the end of the game a couple weeks ago.
And Rivers pulled up for three. It rims out, rebound Broncos. Josh Bryant resetting the offense, passes it to Richmond. Oh, Bryant with the Euro.
Bryant definitely, he Euroed the heck out of that guy. And I think the crowd wanted to travel on the
right.
Union side. But I think he got the ball out right on time.
Bronco foul on number 21, Giles Webster. That's his first, team 8.
When does the Euro end?
Into the game for the Broncos, number 12, Jacob Crutchfield. Also in for the Panthers, number 3, Eric Bowles.
You see Coach Spencer. He's giving his guys, Nakia Rivers and Richmond and Bryant, he's giving them
all the
five minutes
shooting
so
the
far.
Bonus for the Panthers, number 33, Jordan.
A very
Thornton.
Short break, I'm sure. And they'll send number 33 Thornton to the line for the Panthers, 64% on the season. Big body post guy, tries to bully and take it over, but he'll turn it over as well.
And that was Jordan Thornton shooting the free throw. Broncos in the bonus. Yeah, Union pressing. And they cannot get it across the court.
10-second violation.
10-second violation for the Broncos. Possession going to the Panthers.
Tell you what,
to the game for the
Josh
Panthers,
Bryant is walking on eggshells right now with Coach Spencer.
Number 10,
passing that ball
Darian
backwards when he
Peterson.
Probably should have advanced it across the court. Coach Spencer leaving his young guard in there and trusting him, coaching him up at the same time.
Jamal Smith setting up the offense. Marius Pratt with the shot. He misses. Bryant with the rebound.
And you saw Bryant with those impressive hops getting rebounds at a very high rate, which he does. Broncos up 33-24. Pretty low scoring game. Lower scoring game than I thought it would be in the first half after those after the Broncos came out shooting 80% from the three-point line.
And that was Crutchfield.
Offensive foul number 12, Jacob Crutchfield. That's his first.
And he's looking like, man, I don't know what that was. Jamal Smith bringing the ball to the court.
Union trying to get something going here. It slowed it down a little bit. Broncos putting that ball on man defense. Man on ball defense.
Williams with the rebound. Crutchfield trying to find some space. He spins, drives, passes to Williams, and he misses the three.
You saw the kid 12, Crutchfield with the crossover.
Three.
That's three.
Crutchfield. 1 minute left in this half.
And the freshman Crutchfield hits a three. 14% three-point shooter and only 2 points per game. So he's already got more points than what he averages in a game.
Traveling.
That's a travel.
Possession goes to
Will Jenkins. Less than a minute left and a half.
Into the game for the Panthers, number 33, Jordan Thornton.
Crutchfield bringing the ball up the court.
Timeout taken by
the Broncos.
The men of Mount Zion. From the Fayetteville district of the AME
you
Zion
can be ahead
Church,
of the game and purchase your 2019 CIAA basketball tournament tickets from Fayetteville State University Ticket Office. You're invited to the CIAA most anticipated event. Tickets for the 2019 CIAA men's and women's basketball tournament are on sale now at Fayetteville State University Ticket Office. The annual event will once again be held in Charlotte, North Carolina from February 25th to March 2nd, 2019. To purchase general tickets, book your hotel or for information on CIAA tournament events, visit CIAAtournament.org. How do you feel about the CIAA announcing that the tournament will be held in Baltimore in 2021 and 2022?
I was talking to Coach Key about that the other day, man. I told him I thought it was great. You know, a different region completely. Different sites. I love the South, but, you know, going a little closer to the North. A lot of things in Maryland, man. Good she crab soup there.
But for the most part, it's the CIAA doing a good job of making it somewhat fair, giving some home court to Bowie State, Lincoln.
Most definitely. Yep.
Their fans are able to travel better to those places.
Yep.
But I definitely expect the CIAA to be returning to North Carolina.
Yeah, I would like to see it come back to Raleigh.
And this foul on number 12,
Raleigh's grown up a lot since he left.
And, team 7.
You know, two CIAA schools right there
for the Broncos,
in Raleigh. So
number 12, Jacob Crutchfield.
Definitely would like to see it come back at some point.
A lot of the fans were surprised to see it leave Charlotte. CIAA was generating $50 million for it, the Charlotte area.
Yeah. I don't think Charlotte's happy to see it go either. You know,
not at all.
Got to move it around.
That's Crutchfield knocking down his first. Crutchfield, a 58% free throw shooter, knocks down his second.
To the
Broncos
game for the Broncos,
go up 38-24.
Will Brown.
29 seconds left in the half.
The freshman Crutchfield, 5 points. This is a showing for him. He averages 2 points a game, so getting some quality minutes right now.
Jamal Smith bringing the ball up the court. The shot clock is dead.
And do you really expect the Panthers to hold the ball? I mean, to the last shot, they're down 14 points in this first half. I expect them to try to get points on the board as quick as possible.
That's Jenkins to Leach. He jacks one up. He misses. Rebound Broncos. 2 seconds left in the game. In the half.
And that's the end of the first half.
That
Panthers,
is the end of your first half.
Broncos
doing this one 38-24. Broncos doing a great job in showing out for this home crowd. Playing great defensively, getting on the break.
Your leading scorers for the first half is Jaquel Richmond and Nakia Rivers. Both have 6. 11 points for Will Jenkins and the Panthers. Broncos shooting 47% from the field. After shooting 36% from the field, Broncos 50% from the three-point line after shooting an incredible 83% in the first 10 minutes of this game. Panthers only shoot 16%. What is your take on this first half so far, Jordan?
Well, I like the way that the Broncos have come out and been aggressive. They play confident on offense with their shots, taking smart shots. Haven't turned the ball over a whole lot. I saw some mistakes, but definitely want to come out in the second half, clear those up, and I think that they can possibly stretch this lead out even further. This guard play is serious for Fayetteville State. Missed them a lot this season. They're back now. So, yeah, I think they'll be able to keep this going in the second half.
All right, that will be it for us for the half. You have a contest coming up. Look like we're going to get musical cheers. We will be right back after the half.
Ladies and gentlemen, for your halftime entertainment, it's time for Musical Chairs, being brought to you by Coca-Cola. When the music starts, each contestant must dribble the basketball around the chairs. When the music stops, the contestant must dribble the ball to either basket and make a shot. They must continue shooting until they make a basket. Once the basket is made, they are to return to the center court to take a seat in an available chair. When all seats are taken, the contestant left standing is eliminated from the contest. We'll continue this process until only one is left with a chair. Our contestants, John Malayas. John, this is the part where you put the ball up in the air and let people know who you are. John Malayas. Thank you, John. Malayas, is that proper? Malayas? Malayas. Malahias. Okay, like Malhalla. Okay, I got you. Noah Naylor. Deshaun McCoy. Jordan McGugan. Caitlin Chestnut. And Trayshawn Taylor. Who will be the winner of this afternoon's contest of Musical Chairs, being brought to you by Coca-Cola DJ?
It's your boy, you know, Bob King. And I'm back here with something new for y'all.
So there can be only one winner.
It's that bet you can't do a light beat challenge. Let's go, like.
Caitlin, make the basket, girl. See where your mama is. All right. Caitlin has been eliminated. Now there are five. Will it be John? Will it be Noah? Will it be Deshaun? Or will it be Trayshawn or Jordan? Yeah, you've been eliminated. Well, nope. All right. John Malahias has been eliminated. All right, now there's only four. Who will it be? Will it be Noah? I guess the first two letters in your name let you know that it's not Noah. Thank you for participating, Noah. And now there are three. Who will it be? Will it be Deshaun? Jordan? Or Trayshawn? There goes Deshaun. Thank you, Deshaun. Now there are two. Will it be Trayshawn? Or Jordan?
Go!
Who will it be? Congratulations going out to Trayshawn Taylor, the winner of the Musical Chairs, sponsored by Coca-Cola. You just won yourself a Coca-Cola prize pack. Congratulations from all of us here at Fayetteville State University. And now your halftime music being brought to you by Bronco.radio.com, student radio at Fayetteville State University, DJ B Square.
Thank you.
Broncos shooting 46.7% for the
start of the second half of the men's CIAA basketball action. Starting out the second half, Broncos.
Dan Union shooting 36%, 16% from the three-point line. What did you expect for the second half, Jordan?
Like I said, man, I expect them to come out and keep up that pace. I want to see the guards move the ball around like I did before, and want to see Richmond get some good perimeter open looks and lead the second half scoring charge. It seemed like they were doing good when they were following his lead.
Ryan in top of the key pass to Denzel Hoste. Hoste deep from three. He misses. Rebound to Ryan.
You're going to give Hoste those attempts from three-point line, man. You know, really good three-point shooter.
He's a solid three-point shooter.
Yeah, that 30% from the line, man, is deceiving, man. I'm trying to tell you, that guy can shoot.
Raymond Pratt with the drive. He feeds it to Josh Webster. He goes up. He misses. Rebound for Dan Union. Jamal Smith on the break.
Both out of bounds. Possession goes to the Broncos.
Demarius Pitts, but he loses out of bounds. Possession goes to the Broncos.
Webster with a real big, nice big man move, too, on that last possession, man.
Got to
nice
finish.
Man. Yeah, didn't finish, but I like the effort.
Bryant bringing the ball up the court. Virginia Union with the press. And they get Bryant with a travel.
Traveling.
I don't know about that one,
man. Panthers.
Bryant hit him with that fake step. And he came back with the dribble. I think he faked out the referee.
That was that Isaiah Thomas move.
Now, how was that a travel, but got to take three, four, five steps, and that's not a travel? Where is the officiating going in basketball? Not even just on the collegiate level.
Jamal Smith setting up the offense, calls for a screen. He finds.
That's three.
Jordan
for
White
14,
three.
Jordan White.
I'll tell you what, Jordan White is right at about 40% when it comes to three-point shooting, so Virginia Union look to get him going in the second half.
Broncos had a little problems with that press. Jaquel Richmond was able to pass out of it.
Well, you got to let guys
Richmond
get a little slowed down.
Held the basket for Jaquel Richmond.
You got to let the men's Broncos get used to this pace. Let them slow it down a little bit. More than anything, make sure it's in the hands of playmakers.
Smith with the ball. He passes it to Jordan White. That's White with the turnover. Richmond.
Richmond just missed the steal right before that, and he was jumping on that one, man. He got to be happy.
Hawks with the three. And he
knocks
it
down. For Denzel.
That had some contact, too. Denzel Hawks took a slap to the arm there. Should have been a foul.
That is his second three for the day. 3-for-4 from the field. He has 8 points.
Denzel Hoste, pure shooter. Don't want him heated up.
We'll wait to see what the call is.
Virginia
Union gets bailed out from
Joshua
a clear Bryant. Travel.
That's his second.
They get the foul to Joshua Bryant. They say that he grabbed his arm.
Yeah, I think that was a jump ball, if anything, man.
That is Demarius Pitts going to the line for two. Oh, excuse me. They're taking the ball out.
Broncos' opponents only scoring 77 points a game. Virginia Union's at 27 right now in the second half.
Demarius Pitts with the three. He misses. Virginia Union gets charged with a foul.
Panthers foul on number 22,
that
Will Jenkins. That's his
Will
first
Jenkins.
Team first.
Second chance points right now in favor of Fayetteville State, 15-2. Huge difference right now, man. They're making their second chances count.
Ball deflected by
Virginia
Union.
Possession remains with the Broncos.
Possession remains with the Broncos.
Raymond Pratt taking the ball out of bounds.
They'll swing the ball around up top. Those guards, man, they're getting effective. And Host just gave off an elbow to number 12, Jamal Smith.
Bronco foul on number 10, Denzel Host. That's his first, team second.
And they hit Host with the person with the offensive foul.
Smith will get up though and walk off since the arc.
Jamal Smith bringing the ball up the court. Broncos doing a good job of not allowing Will Jenkins to get the ball offensively. As he sets the screen, Smith for three, and he knocks it down.
That's three for Jamal Smith.
Smith comes back with that injured face, his three-pointer.
That three ball reduces the deficit to a 13-point game. Broncos lead 43-230, 16 minutes left in half.
Some good ball movement down here on the court by the Broncos in this possession.
Hoist to Richmond. Richmond trying to find a shot. He throws one up.
Richmond,
nearly
I think,
makes it.
I think he was looking to get fouled there, and he may have.
Foul number 21, Giles Webster.
Giles Webster with the offensive foul.
Team third.
His second foul.
Regime change coming up.
Smith tries
balls
to get
out of bounds.
Murray's
possession
pitch
goes
on the
to
inside,
the
and he loses it. Ball's out of bounds. That's the Broncos. Broncos have a platoon switch. Will Brown comes back into the game. Xavier Williams, Mark Burton.
You see Burton's mom up there in the stands cheering him on.
Nakia Rivers also enters the game. Jerry Union doing a good job with the trap.
I'll tell you what, Nakia Rivers is fouled there. Hit pretty hard in the face, it was like. Rest over the whistle.
And they get Nakia Rivers with another trap.
This goes to the Panthers.
Coach Spencer giving some good tips to his guys. Nakia Rivers knows he made a mistake there on that play.
Dan Union's head coach arguing that the clock was running. It's Terrell Leach with the penetration, the layup. He misses. Rebound, Will Brown.
I'd like to see Brown back in there getting those rebounds as well as Fayetteville State has been doing with second chance points today.
And Williams is calling for the ball on the inside. Will Brown with a hot step to pass to Mark Burton for three. He misses it.
Burton will be pushed out of bounds.
Burton with the dive and the steal. Let's see where they give
balls
it to. They give it to Virginia Union.
Possession goes to the Panthers. Timeout taken by the Panthers.
Timeout, Panthers.
For all the up-to-date information about Fayetteville State Athletics, visit the official
Assistance
website
ice cold
at FSUBroncos.com.
It's the perfect refreshment for
also keep
fans
up with
FSU
Athletics on Facebook,
on
Twitter, and YouTube
taste
at FSUBroncos,
taste
as well as on Instagram at
FSU_Broncos.
Well, it seems like they came out in the second half kind of looking to get the same place going as far as the Broncos go. But Virginia Union's been doing a pretty good job on defense so far. So I expect Coach Spence to get something different going, man, something to beat this press. Just
find a way to get the ball in the basket. Possibly work a little bit more in the paint. They only got 16 points in the paint right now out of those 43 points. So I expect them to come out, do a little bit more work down low, possibly break up some of that press action.
Broncos struggling to score a little bit. What do they need to do to kind of pick up that pace?
Well, like I said, I think they need to get the ball inside. Started off early, you know, shooting well from downtown. Like we said, 83% from three-point field goal, now at 46.7%. So you definitely want to see them get in the paint a little bit more now.
That was Jamal Smith with the drive and the layup. Will Brown just throwing out
of number 13, the atmosphere. Mark Burton.
Looked like
that's his second
the
team
foul was called on the Broncos.
On the line shooting two
Jamal
for
Smith
the Panthers,
going to the line
number 12,
two.
Jamal Smith.
Jamal Smith is a 79% free throw. He's a 79% free throw shooter.
Into the game for the Panthers, number 15, Jordan Peebles.
Well, this will be Jordan Peebles coming on. Big time athlete out of Emporia, Virginia.
Smith misses his second. Panthers get the rebound. Putback is rimmed out. And they force a turnover, Broncos turnover.
Burton looked like he was fouled there.
He did. Jamal Smith slowing it down, resetting the offense.
Burton coming out of Tokyo, Japan via Clark Atlanta. Now at Fayetteville State University Bronco.
And that's Will Jenkins with the drive and the layup.
Will Jenkins.
Broncos lead by 10, 43-33.
And Nakia Rivers misses a pass on the wing, I was going to say. And they'll eventually find it, but it'll be too late.
And the Broncos turn the ball over again.
Union has nowhere to go with the ball right now. It's been a defensive lock so far. A 10-point lead for the Broncos.
5 seconds on the shot clock. They get it inside to White. He misses the jump shot. Williams with the rebound on the break. Finds Burton.
Burton sliced the defense.
With the crossover and the layup for two.
Onto
the line. Burton. For one more.
Yeah, Burton definitely got the best of the defense there. Weaved outside and inside. Into the paint.
Panther foul on number
off of the
two,
miss
the
by
Americans
number 22,
miss.
Will Jenkins, who
that's his
I spoke
first
on earlier, man.
Team
the best
second
player. He's been staggered today, man.
Well, the
only 13 points,
the
and they've come
13,
hard.
Broncos substitute Marquise Crutchfield in for Xavier Williams. Burton makes his free throw.
But the Broncos are definitely making it hard for Virginia Union to get anything going on offense. And steadily putting up points to build onto their lead.
Eric Balls with the ball. He finds Jordan White. He turns around, passes it to White, and he makes the layup.
Will Jenkins.
Broncos turn the ball over. And that was Terrell Leach with the ill-advised three.
Yeah,
rebound.
Leach tried to draw some contact behind on Richmond, but Richmond with the smart play to just stay away from him while he shot that three.
Jordan White rebounds and puts it back for two. Bring this ball game in within 2-9. For all the up-to-date information about Fayetteville State Athletics, visit the official FSU Athletics website at www.fsubroncos.com. Also, keep up with FSU Athletics on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube at FSU Broncos, as well as on Instagram at FSU_Broncos. Broncos leading this ball game 46-37 with 12 minutes and 32 seconds left in this half in this game. Broncos need to do to kind of make sure they take this
home. Well, they got to keep their foot on the gas, man. This is not time to to ease up or to, you know, lack aggression on offense. You still want to keep the same intensity going on defense. And to be honest, Union isn't helping themselves with some of their shot attempts, man, as well as the fact that they can't get any second chance points. So Fayetteville State just needs to keep the pace up, man, and they'll be able to hold on to this lead.
Union was shooting 16% in that first half from the three-point line, had brought that percentage up to 37.5%, shooting 40% overall. They're trying to fight their way back into this game.
They are, and it's going to be a tough, long fight, and it's going to come down probably to the last couple of shots, but Fayetteville State, I think, is going to keep control.
And the Broncos have been struggling.
Balls out of bounds.
Get the ball up the court and get the press.
To the Broncos.
Did a good job of getting it, breaking the press this possession. Ball deflected out of bounds by the Virginia Union. It's Crutchfield with the inbound.
And you see Union, their coaches are calling out to make sure they know where the shooters are. Well, it looked like it was going to be a foul call on number 0 to
Terrell Leach. Possession goes to the Panthers.
But the refs called the backcourt instead. I think one of the refs was calling a foul, actually, and the other ref called a backcourt.
Yeah, it did appear to be a foul. You hear the crowd growing impatient, all calling for a foul. And that's the case that Coach Spencer is making. Will Jenkins at the top of the key. Crossover, spin around, layup, and he makes it.
Will Jenkins.
Jenkins just takes Brown on the ISO move. We see Jenkins trying to get some of that juice going that we've heard so much about. I'm sure Will Brown will be up for the contest. As Nakia Rivers is fouled this time, and they will call it on 0.
Panthers foul on number 0, Terrell Leach. That's his first, team third.
Might be 13 fouls on Virginia Union. So, like I said, man, not a lot of mistakes for Union, man. They just haven't been able to score throughout the game, and Fayetteville State has, man. Fayetteville State holding on to a 7-point lead now, 46-39.
Here, Rivers passes to Burt for 3, and he knocks it down. Broncos come up 49-39 with 11 minutes left in this game.
And that's what you expect to see right there later in the games, in the second half, in particular for Fayetteville State. Burton hitting threes, also Rivers and Richmond.
Burton leading the Broncos in scoring with 9 points. Will Brown with the block.
Fumbles the layup, and then Brown called for a foul on the block.
Should have came down with the rebound. That was Jordan White that went up and got fouled. He would be going to the line for 2.
On the line, shooting 2 for the Panthers, number 14, Jordan White.
Will Brown has to bring that rebound down. Jordan White is a 64% free throw shooter. He misses his first.
To the game for the Panthers.
Yeah, rave on Will Brown shot blocking up, but back got to come
Broncos,
down with those tough physical rebounds.
Jaquel Richmond, number 21.
And you can see he's down on himself right now, man. Missed the rebound and picks up the foul. He'll go to the bench. Definitely will come back looking for something.
Jordan White makes his second. Burton breaks the press single-handedly, passes it to Richmond. Richmond to Rivers on the wing. Rivers for 3.
Rivers.
He misses it.
Rivers wanted to take that 3 at first, but his rhythm was off, so he got it back to Richmond, and then he got it back and felt a little better about it.
3, and it looks like they hit Virginia Union with the foul.
Offensive foul on number 15.
Jordan Peoples.
That's his third, team
6'6 guard out of Emporia.
Richmond knowing how to throw that weight around.
Crushfield on the interior. No look pass to Webster. He gets the ball back and gets it up for two.
Gotta love that eye on the glass. Crushfield looked for the pass. It wasn't there. He got it back. Made the easy layup underneath after making the guy jump. Good basketball down low in the second half of Fayetteville State. Slow, steady fight, but they're holding on to their lead. They jumped it back up to an 11-point lead. 10 minutes left in the game.
Passes to Jamal Smith. Jamal Smith drives, shoots, misses, rebound to Webster.
And that was a very uncomfortable shot. Burton and Richmond are going to work at the top. Kind of slow things down. I'm looking for them to feed it back inside into Crutchfield, man. And there he goes.
He loses it. Rivers has saved the ball from being stolen. He finds Burton in the corner. Knocks down the three. Broncos go up. 4-40. 9 minutes left to go.
Burton doing his best Steph Curry impression, man. He's knocking those three-pointers down. That'll be 12 points for Burton. He's 3 of 4 from the three-point line.
That's Terrell Leek setting up the offense. He drives. Finds Will Jenkins. He puts it up for the layup. He misses. Rebound Richmond. Broncos have numbers. Find Rivers in the corner. He misses the three. Rebound. The Panthers. That's Terrell Leek. Layup. He gets fouled. That's Richmond with the foul.
Richmond with a smart foul there. And no easy buckets down low.
That's his
Bronco
second
foul. Bronco foul number three, Jaquel Richmond. That's his third, team six. Media timeout.
The National Guard is a proud sponsor of Fayetteville State Athletics. Always ready, always there. The National Guard continues its historic dual mission, providing trained units to the states, territories, and the District of Columbia, and keeping its sub equipped to protect the life and property. The Guard is also provides trained units to the nation, equipped and ready to defend the United States and its interests all over the globe. Visit www.nationalguard.com for more information on the National Guard.
Being brought to you by Buffalo Wings.
Broncos lead this game 54-40. 8 minutes and 59 seconds left in this game.
14-point lead, Arthur. I expect these guys to keep the dance going, man. Like I said, the game plan is working. They're playing good defense. They're getting their second chance points. 14 points off of turnovers, 20 points in the paint. The numbers are actually pretty staggering on the other end for the Panthers in the second half. But Fayetteville State, they control their own fate right now.
That's Terrell Leach going to the line for two.
One thing different right now about this game, the Broncos shooting
the line for the Panthers, shooting two,
from the free throw line.
Number zero,
meanwhile,
Terrell
Union shooting 53% from the free throw line. So, big difference at the line.
Leach makes his first. Second.
So Leach, 80% free throw shooter, does what he's supposed to do, knocks it down.
Richmond gets the ball across the half court. He slows down the offense.
Yeah, Richmond has a real good feel right now for this game. He knows they're up. He's their floor general. He's going to make sure there aren't any turnovers. Get that clock down low.
Downtown. Miss it, Burton with the rebound.
Burton will get it back and he'll just kill some more time, I think.
Well, Yeah, he's showing his handles.
Yeah, Burton has a really good ball handle.
Crutchfield with the jump shot and knocked down the
Crutchfield. Crutchfield said, I'm not wasting time. He took his shot. The big guy with the opportunity sinks it. And now playing some good defense. You see these Fayetteville State Broncos putting on a defensive clinic, really.
Leach with the drive and the layup that he got Broncos bailed out.
Number 33, Marquise Crutchfield. That's his second, team seven.
That's Marquise Crutchfield's second foul.
8 minutes left in the second half, man.
For the Panthers,
and Panthers are only at 42 points, and they average 75, man. Fayetteville State Broncos on great pace to take these guys off of their average scoring. I think that's a recipe for victory.
Leach misses his first.
The Panthers, number 3, Eric Bowles, and number 22, Will Jenkins.
Leach knocks down her second.
No stranger to making free throws.
Look like the Broncos in trouble.
And they'll get it
nearly
up
get stolen. Crutchfield to Burton.
Really good pass on Burton.
With the penetration.
Rivers.
He misses the layup. Well, Webster with the rebound. And he misses the putback. Fortunately, the ball stays with the Broncos. Deflected out of bounds by the Virginia Union Panthers.
Real scrappy play in the paint.
Richmond with the inbound. He finds Crutchfield for three. He drives and gets fouled. He'll be going to the line for two.
I didn't think the big man was going to go for that 3-point attempt.
It looked like he thought about it.
I think he thought about it, man, but he did right. He drove it in.
He faked me out.
On the line, shooting two for the Broncos, number 33, Marquise Crutchfield.
Crutchfield is, as we spoke on earlier, boosting up that zero free throw percentage with a couple of makes on today.
Already 2 for 3 from the field. Third
to the game for the Panthers, number 12, Jamal Smith. And number 33, Jordan Thornton.
Virginia Union goes through their substitutions. Look like they're doing a little offensive defense now.
I'll tell you what, the Broncos are up 15 now. If they continue this success at the free throw line, I don't see these guys.
Oh, Crutchfield with the steal on the break by himself, and he gets it!
Crutchfield will throw it down. And you see the Broncos stands erupt. They're going to have to call a timeout, man.
Crutchfield is ecstatic.
Broncos with the foul. Well, Richmond, that's his fourth.
As Crutchfield plays to the crowd. He's a big, swole guy. He's not little.
And that is the crowd's Richmond's fourth foul. With 7 minutes left in this game. Do you leave Richmond in the game?
On the line, shooting the bonus for the Panthers.
I'm not going to lie, man. I take him out. I probably put him in around 5-4 minutes left because you definitely want him closing the game, but you don't want to take him off the court long enough for the Panthers to make a run.
Into the game for the
They're
Broncos,
down 17.
20, Joshua Bryant.
That's the Marius Pitt making his
also
first
back
free
in
throw.
For the Panthers, number 14, Jordan
Wright. He is a 66% free throw shooter on the year.
I'll tell you what, man, all those calf muscles that Marquise Crutchfield got, I was expecting him to throw that down.
Burton bringing the ball up the court.
Burton looking to break some ankles.
Left him with the screen. Crutchfield on the wing. And he gets blocked on the backboard.
Ball's out of bounds.
That one will be blocked.
Possession goes to the Panthers.
Nice attempt. He tried to make a move inside Crutchfield did.
Made a nice move. It's Virginia Union. They recovered.
Into the game for the Panthers. Number 22, Will Jenkins.
Broncos lead this one 60-45 with 6 minutes and 53 seconds left to go in this ball game.
Into the game for the Broncos, number 2, Xavier
Williams coming in for the dunk master, Marquise Crutchfield.
So the crowd gives Crutchfield a little standing ovation as he goes off the court.
Lamar Smith for 3. He knocks it down.
That's 3 for Jamal Smith.
Bringing the Broncos lead within 12.
Well, Smith looking to play tight on Josh Bryan as Josh Bryan tries to advance it, and he gets trapped again.
And he does a good job to find him Xavier Williams.
Timeout taken by the Broncos.
Timeout by the Broncos.
Fans, you can be ahead of the game and purchase your 2019 CIAA basketball tournament tickets from the Fayetteville State University ticket office. You're invited to the CIAA's most anticipated event.
What was you thinking when Crutchfield got that steal and broke for that dunk?
I was thinking, man, throw it down. Throw it down, big guy. That's what I was thinking, man. And he lived up to the hype, man. He was supposed to be dunking on these guys, and he dunked on that guy right there.
Absolutely. He did not let the crowd down.
I mean, he just made the steal. I kind of thought he wasn't going to get away with that one. And then had the speed to break away, so very impressive on the big man.
Here, Rivers with the inbound.
Throws it back to Josh Bryan.
In the backcourt. And they get Bryant with another travel.
I think that was a foul there before a travel.
Position goes to the Panthers.
Coach Spencer getting on Josh Bryant, man. Hasn't been the best day for Bryant. Made some mistakes. Bryant in 0 points today. Very, very unlike Josh Bryant, which is 18 points a game in the season.
Jamal Smith with the drive layup. He misses. That's Will Jenkins with the putback.
Yeah, Will Jenkins Will trying Jenkins. To get something going for his team. He has 17 points right now. Leading all players, actually. 19 points, excuse me.
And that's Will Jenkins with the foul.
Panthers foul on number 22.
Here,
Will
Rivers
Jenkins.
Come up hobbling.
That's his second, team 6.
Looks like there was some contact to that upper thigh.
Josh Bryant with the inbound. Burton setting up the offense.
We'll go back to Burton. Man.
Burton for 3. Oh. He misses.
Burton
rebound leaps.
Knocks it right
he
off the rim.
Jordan White, he misses the point blank layup.
That'll be no basket, so it ended up being a good foul on Burton. And they didn't call the foul on Burton, actually. They called it on 21 Giles Webster.
That's his third team.
The sophomore center, 6'7 guy.
On the line shooting the bonus.
Jordan White going to the line for 2.
Number 14.
5:40
Jordan
left on the clock,
White.
And the Broncos are nursing this 10-point lead.
Jordan White knocks down his first. Jordan White, the 6'6'4 from Frederick, Maryland, is a 64% free throw shooter. Knocks down his second.
Broncos have numbers. Job. Broncos did a good job of getting that ball to the other side of the floor.
Possession remains to the Broncos.
That trap defense has done okay for the Panthers, but the Broncos are finding their way through it.
As the Panthers deflect the ball out of bounds, Burton with the inbound to Bryant.
see Burton dribbling around trying to find some open room.
He finds Williams with the pass to Brown inside. He misses the layup. He will be going to the line for two.
Yeah, and Bryant is getting on
the
home
stuff
about that.
Jordan Thornton.
And you mentioned Bryant, who is averaging 17 points a game
on the line,
season.
Shooting two for the Broncos. It's 0-4 Joshua Bryant
today, with the possibility of getting his first points on the board.
Yeah, and that'll maybe do something for the confidence for him late in this game. If Josh can score his points in the final 5 minutes of this game, I don't think they'll be sorry to see him show up this late.
Josh Bryant makes his first free throw. He's a 63% free throw shooter on the year. Knocks down the second. It's Jamal Smith, Jordan White for three, and he knocks it down.
This is good by Jordan White. Timeout taken by the Panthers.
Union brings that Broncos lead down to 7. Broncos lead 62-55. 5 minutes and 16 seconds left in this ball game.
I expect to see Richmond come back on the floor after this timeout. Possibly Crutchfield as well, man, just to get the pace going back up. And get some of those second chance points like the Broncos being so successful doing in the first half. Coach will hold off on sending back in Richmond, as well as Crutchfield. I wonder how long.
Yeah, with four fouls and 5 minutes left in this game, you don't want Richmond to foul out. As Josh Bryant's called a timeout, he had trouble getting down the ball.
Timeout taken by the Broncos.
And with that timeout, Saturday, February 9th, 2019, against Johnson C. Smith University, the ball and pink basketball game. Wear pink and help make a difference. Universities across the nation are unifying together and helping to raise money through an annual basketball game spotlighting breast cancer awareness. This is the 10th year that Fayetteville State University is participating. Game fans can show support of breast cancer awareness by purchasing a candy bar, other gift items, and or by making a donation. Student volunteers will be in the stands throughout the game selling items and collecting money. Checks and credit cards will be accepted. Breast cancer survivors who express interest in attending the game will be given complimentary admission and special seating in the chancellor section. Miss Nancy Anderson will host a special reception and recognition ceremony for survivors and students of the women's game. The women's game begins at 1 p.m.
If you're interested in attending,
contact Mike King at 910-672-2565 or email mjking@ufcfsued.edu. The deadline to register is 5 p.m. on February 4th, 2019.
You see, they'll come back with Crutchfield and Richmond on the floor. So coach didn't wait too long to put those guys back in as that lead was cut down to 7 points. As Crutchfield, as Richmond will get the ball inbound.
And you got to get the ball across the half court.
Yeah, he knew it.
As Richmond passes to Crutchfield, looks like they call a foul on
that is
zero,
foul number
Terrell
zero,
Leach.
Terrell Leach. That's his second, team eight.
His second foul.
To the game for the Panthers.
Bonus,
number two,
going to
Demarius Pitts.
Demarius Pitts will check in for the Panthers. Big time
on the line shooting the
bonus
for the Broncos, number
Pitts,
three.
15 points, 9 points a game, right at 16 points a game. So They're looking to make a push on the scoring side as Fayetteville State looks to keep this lead going as Richmond misses that second free throw.
Jamal Smith bringing the ball up the court.
Broncos really locked in right now on defense, making sure they got their assignments. Man on ball defense as Burton does a heck of a job just stopping Smith on that drive.
Burton finds Richmond for three, and it rims out.
I thought Richmond hit that one, man. It looked like a good look as he picks it off right out of the air. Heck of a defensive play, man. Looked like he played a little cornerback right there.
Burton bringing the ball to the court, passes to Richmond. Richmond setting up the offense. Burton with the handles.
Yeah, man. Burton is putting on a clinic with these handles today. And so is Richmond, low-key. He's fouled there at the top of the key.
That is foul on number 12, Jamal Smith. That's his third, team ninth.
Jamal Smith has been fouling a lot in the second half, seems like. Playing real aggressive, man, trying to figure something out against Richmond, who's giving him everything he can handle. As well as Mark Burton.
Broncos shooting 44% from the field, 40% from the three-point line. 9 for 11 from the free throw line, doing a good job at the free throw line. Normally, we don't really see the Broncos shoot that well from the free throw line.
Yeah, free throw line. Early in the game, three-point line, too.
Panthers shooting 39% from the field, 45% from the three-point line, 66% from the free throw line. Both teams are in the bonus. 4 minutes left in the game. I'm going to leave this game 65.
A quick break.
And he lays it up and misses it.
Oh, and it's almost put back.
Burton for the three-pointer. And he nails
three for Mark Burton.
Mark Burton, 3 for 5 from the three-point line. Excuse me, 4 for 6 from the three-point line right now. Mark Burton, 15 points.
Yep, he leads the Broncos with 15 points.
Bronco foul on number 33, Marquise Crutchfield. That's his third, team 10.
What Burton is having a game day performance today. His career high, 20 points.
Number zero, Terrell
season high, 19 points. So he's knocking on his season high right now.
Leach makes his first
substitution into the game for the Panthers.
See, the league has been
Eric
cut to 11
Bowles,
after it was 12, but it 15, was down to 9, Jordan and it was Peebles. Down to 7 points. So you see, the Broncos, they're just able to just keep this lead up, man. And not completely lose control, still able to score. I think Richmond coming back in helped that pace a little bit. As you see Crutchfield preparing for the rebound down low.
Leach misses his second, rebound Burton. He crosses over, Jordan Peebles. And Richmond does an excellent job of passing out in front and finds Charles Webster, and the foul.
Charles Webster,
Panthers foul on number
the
two,
big man, down low, put it in there,
team
and he'll get fouled. Charles Webster goes to the line.
Well, the
line 61% free throw.
Broncos, number 21.
But did you see
Giles
the jump pass
Webster
from Jaquel Webster? For Jaquel Richmond, to find Webster.
Yeah, most definitely, man. You got to give Richmond credit, man. I mean, the guy's a floor general. He sees it all.
Webster misses his free throw. That's Aaron Bowles setting up the offense.
Jordan Peebles
with the rebound and the putback. Dan Union with the press again. And they get Terrell Leach with
Panthers foul on number zero, Timmy Leach. That's his third. Coming to the line with two shots for the Broncos, number 13, Mark Burton.
Mark Burton going to the line for two.
Into the game for the Panthers, number 14, Jordan White.
Free throw shooter on the year.
Yeah, Burton will knock down those shots, man. Come to the free throw line and get you some clutch free throws. Only 3 minutes left on the clock. The Broncos holding on to a 12-point lead, which has turned into a 13-point lead, thanks to Burton's two free throws made at the line.
Aaron Bowles bringing the ball to the court. He finds Leach for three. He knocks it down.
That's three for Terrell Leach. Leach.
Back to 10. Burton bringing the ball to the court. He finds Rivers. Rivers finds Richmond.
Burton passed it right between Leach's legs to get it up court.
Richmond setting up the offense. Richmond and Burton kind of ran into each other there.
Not kind of. They ran into each other. Just made Richmond pick his dribble up, but he'll put it back on the floor and he'll get
Richmond
into the paint.
Richmond with the drive. Layup misses.
Webster and Crutchfield, a little miscommunication.
And that's Panthers. Demarius Smith going up with the dunk.
Nakia Rivers just missed the defensive assignment. Rivers got to get back on defense on that play as the guys get back on offense.
And that's Richmond setting the offense up again, slowing it down. Burton finds Rivers. Rivers drives, layup. He misses.
Air ball. Rivers struggling in the past couple possessions.
Broncos do a good job getting back on defense. But Aaron Bowles brings that defense Spence with the Euro step and the layup up and under. Drops this game within six.
Yeah. Guys got to start getting back into their groove, man. Fayetteville State is slowed down and they're lacking aggression on offense.
The FSU Broncos in this game 71-65 with 1 minute and 41 seconds left in the ball. Now I can reload right up in his spot just to get my stats up. Now I'm back on deck. So shout it with our shoot. You are early top of shoot. But this ain't what the fuck you want. Lock my CEO up. Now it's back to them. Talking shoot.
See, Richmond is the one with the ball in his hands late, as usual. He'll just throw the ball away. You got to slow it down there, Richmond.
Absolutely. Oh. And they hit Rivers with a foul on Leach, shooting a three. He will be going to the line for three.
Bronco foul on number 11, Nakia Rivers.
Nakia Rivers is really struggling, man, late in this game. On defense and then a little too much defense on that possession right there as he'll foul Leach and he'll go to the line.
On the line
three.
Shooting three for the Panthers, number zero, Terrell Leach.
Within three. Broncos in 71-65. As Terrell Leach goes to the line for three.
Leach at 80% three free throw.
And he misses his first.
He'll miss his first. A little jitters coming on.
That's got to be a painful one.
Jitters coming on that first free throw. Let's shoot a second.
knocks down her second. Like I said, Leach is an 80% free throw shooter.
Leach has 11 points on the day and is 5-for-8 from the free throw line so far.
Into the game for the Panthers, number 12, Jamal Smith.
1 minute, 27 seconds left in this ball game.
Broncos be up 4 points. They try to inbound the ball.
Richmond's in Crutchfield does a good job of slowing it down.
And the Broncos will get the ball around. Broncos is trying to protect the ball at this point.
Crutchfield, good pass to Burton. And Burton passes out of a layup to Burton for three. He misses.
Yeah, that was definitely a mistake made by Josh Bryant.
And Will Jenkins drives for the layup. He misses. And they hit Rivers with another foul. And Rivers is not, he does not like the call.
Nakia Rivers, that's his second.
What happened on that possession, Jordan? Bryant was there in the paint by himself with an open layup.
I think he overthought it a little bit, man. He should have just went up on the quick layup after that pump fake, and he kicked it out to Burton. I don't really know. I think it was just a mistake. Definitely could have used those 2 points, though, to take this back up to a 6-point lead. It's a 4-point lead now, and the Panthers are at the line. Their best scorer is at the line now. Missed his first free throw.
Will Jenkins at 57%.
Well, the Panthers, like all – the Panthers, like all game, man, they've just been in their own way. Hope that the Broncos can pick up some offense on this next possession.
He misses both. Jay Union with the rebound. And he gets fouled.
Bronco foul on number 13.
Well, the Broncos just have to slow down. That was a foul on number 13, Mark Burton. He just went after it a little too tough.
And Burton's like, is that on me?
It was definitely on you, Burton. Devil State has slowed down a little bit, man. Play good defense, stop sending these guys to the line. You're giving them too many opportunities.
Yes, Aaron Bowles going to the line for two. He's a 66% free throw shooter on the year. He makes his first. Panthers pull it within three. Now's the second. This is a 2-point ball game, ladies and gentlemen. 59 seconds left to go.
At one point was a 17-point lead.
Bryant turns the ball over. It looks like we have a jump ball. Possession arrow goes to the Panthers.
Possession goes to the Panthers.
Got to think Josh Bryant is shooting himself in the foot right now as Coach Spence just takes him off the court. A lot of mistakes late in the game.
Number 14, Jordan White.
Tell him to brush it off.
Can't be mad for Spence taking Bryant out.
To the game for the Panthers,
Bryant not really having the best
of
games. Shooting.
Yeah, trouble's down the line, man. 18 points a game usually for Josh Bryant, man. He's just struggled all day, so. Expect to see Fayetteville State play some good defense today.
Coach Spencer is calling for the trap. Jamal Smith with the ball. Looking for Leach on the inside. Leach posts up and misses the layup that could have tied the game. And that's Jordan White with the rebound and the quarterback. And ladies and gentlemen, this ball game is tied 71-71.
And this ball game is tied for the first time in this new life in this stadium. On both
sides.
Shot
clock is dead. 16 seconds to go. That's Richmond.
And this game has the makings of a great one.
Pulls up a three. Misses. Rebound Panthers.
At the end of the ball game.
This is going to overtime.
71-71. Overtime.
What? just happened. Broncos leading this game, most of this game. Panthers able to climb back into it and tie this game 71-71 going to Oakland.
Well, the Panthers, they surged all the way back, man. And it seems like the Broncos, man, they turned the ball over a lot. Like, the Broncos sitting at 19 turnovers right now. They went in the second half with only 9. And I want to say the last 6 came in under 5 minutes. I mean, just real messy play by the Fayetteville State Broncos right now in these last few minutes of this game. You got to hope guys get it together, man. 17-point lead, Arthur, with 8 minutes left on the clock.
I have no explanation for it.
No explanation, man. What can you say? If the Broncos don't change the way they're taking care of the ball, it'll be more of this in overtime.
This is a new ball game in overtime. Game tied 71-71. Broncos have to make some adjustments. They did not play well in that second half.
Not at all. I expect to see a unit on the floor that's going to take care of the ball, play defense, and be able to score inside and out. This game, I don't think this game should be in overtime right now.
Black minute overtime.
So the Virginia Union Panthers won't press. It's surprising, even though it's overtime and it's tied up. I expect them to keep that same intensity, man, but they're not. So maybe Fayetteville State will be able to get something going with their guards like they were earlier in this game.
Finds Crutchfield on inside. He gets blocked.
Crutchfield just blocked there.
And that is Demarius Pitts gets charged.
Offensive foul number 2, Demarius Pitts. That's his 3rd.
This game, just gotta hope guys can keep possession of the ball, not turn it over, and make some good scores towards the end.
Crutchfield with a rebound to put back, he misses. Rebound Panthers. And the Panthers, the Broncos are struggling to score.
They are, man, and they're second guessing themselves. They're doing the opposite of what they did in the first half. Unconfident shots, man, down low and on the perimeter. Just haven't been confident shooting the ball.
Another charge called on the Panthers. Offensive foul being charged to Terrell Leach. That is his 4th foul. And that's the thing about overtime, Jordan. They don't take away fouls.
To the game
so
the Panthers,
now you're going
three,
to overtime
Eric
with a lot
Bowles.
Of your players in foul trouble. And it's hard to kind of make those adjustments, especially defensively.
Yeah. And, you know, it's just like Fayetteville State, man. They're missing like one shot, literally one shot, man. They got these guys under 75 points in the first half. In regulation, you would think they'll be able to win the game, seeing how that's well below their average. And Fayetteville State scored actually more than their average. So
that was Rivers wisely bringing the ball back out. Richmond with the spin layup misses. Panthers with the rebound. Broncos seem to be on a mean scoring drought. Jenkins on the inside. He misses.
Jordan
followed
White.
Up by Jordan White. He knocks down the layup. And Virginia Union takes that first lead of the ball game, 73-71.
I'll tell you, White. Jordan White, 73-71.
Richmond knocks down the jump shot to tie this game back up.
You want to see Richmond take these shots late, man. He's the guy. Josh Bryant has been struggling this game. He's the other top scorer. So you kind of have to leave it in the hands of a Richmond and a Burton to hit those big shots towards the end.
Now, Darren Biles is driving a dish to Will Jenkins for the dunk. That's 75-73. 1 minute and 55 seconds left in this game. Burton finds Richmond. Richmond to Rivers for three. He misses. Panthers with the rebound. They're slowing it down.
Broncos just got to stay tough here, man. You see some distress in the face of some of these players. And you don't want that.
Broncos fans, don't forget the next home game is this Monday against Kentucky State University. Women tip-off time is 5:30 p.m. and the men tip-off at 7:30 p.m. General initiatives only 12 hours. This Monday,
he's telling the guys one, take care of the ball. Technically telling them to take the best shot attempt you can, man. I would be telling them to make sure I'm on those offensive boards. I would definitely, if I were Coach Spence right now, I would have in William Brown with Crutchfield. Seeing as how, man, those are my two best rebounders and putback guys. And when we were leading, it was second chance points that were keeping them ahead. At one point, it was 20-2. Now it's 22-17.
Rebound category, 40-38.
36 points also in the paint for the Union to 26. Huge difference from the second half.
17 second chance points for the Panthers. As Aaron Bowles set the offense up. White, jump shot, and he knocks it down in the paint.
William Jenkins.
Excuse me, that was William Jenkins.
Yeah, William Jenkins, the best player on Union, is leading a push in this second half. You know, you expect the Broncos guys to step up. That's Richmond looking for a spot right now.
Richmond with the drive and the layup. He misses. Rebound Jenkins. And Richmond is down. We have a Broncos injury.
Looks like it may have came down on somebody's foot.
Panthers game 77-73. 43 seconds left in this ball game.
You hate to see that. That's the ankle that's already taped. Yeah, late in the game, you hate to see this, man. Only down 4 points. He's holding on to a 17-point lead. Now in overtime, only up four. Your head guy goes down.
Yeah, you hate to see your player go down this late in the game.
Silence in the gym. It's really all right. It really felt the state's top player.
Let's hear it for Jaquel Richmond.
Richmond will come off the court.
Crutchfield carries Richmond off the court.
Gonna get his guy off the floor.
That's Denzel Host coming back in the game for Richmond. Haven't seen him in quite some time.
As you see Hosh come in, surprising that Hosh wasn't on the floor earlier, seeing as how he may be the best other than Burton at the three-point shot.
I agree.
Into the game for the Broncos, number 10, Denzel Holsch.
I'm looking for Hosh and Burton, man, to get me an early three-point attempt, fast in the clock. Don't foul right away, though. And they're calling it.
Bronco foul on number 10, Denzel Hosh. That's his second.
And did they really need the foul right there?
I don't think they needed to, but it's the
I don't think they were trying to get away from the foul.
You're only down two possessions.
Right. Maybe didn't need the foul.
It pays off. Eric Bowles misses his first.
And they will with Host. As Host just loses the ball. Oh, man, you hate to see that.
Terrell Leach.
That's Leach with the open layup. Burton with the drive and the charge.
Offensive foul on number 13, Mark Burton. That's his fifth personal foul.
That's his fifth.
12 points left on the clock as you start to see the stands clear out.
Number 12, Jacob Crutchfield.
Yeah, 80-73 right now. The Panthers leading the Broncos. That will do it. Panthers just run the clock down in overtime.
The end of the ball game. Panthers 80. That is Broncos your ball 73. Game.
Virginia Union Panthers taking this one 80.
Fans, don't forget this Monday, Bowie State University comes to the Capel Arena. The women tip off at 5:30 p.m. Men tip off at 7:30 p.m. General admission tickets are only $12. As you make your way home, you have to drive safely for yourself, the other guy, the other guy.
Turnovers, Arthur. 26 for Virginia Union, which seemed to all come in the first half. 16 only for the Broncos, which seemed to all come in the second half, especially when it counted, man. And from some key players, man, Josh Bryant, one of the leading scorers today, struggled, man, especially late in the game, turned the ball over a few times. I mean, 17-point lead, Arthur, in the second half, 8 minutes left. And the Broncos just couldn't seem to get any offense going after that. So I would have to say that the Broncos beat themselves today.
I agree with you, Jordan. Definitely agree with that. I have no explanation for why the Broncos lost that lead.
Yeah, me neither. That was real disappointing, man. Conference play. Virginia Union coming in, they were the defending champs. You had them down 17 points and just couldn't hold on, man.
Absolutely. All right, you can catch us next time here in the Capel Arena going against Bowie State. That will be January 14th, Monday at 7:30. That is our game for today, ladies and gentlemen. I am Marcus James for my partner, Jordan Collier. We bid you adieu.